Thank you. We give you praise. We give you glory, Lord. Thank you, Father, for you can do anything. You can heal every disease. You can change any situation that seems to be impossible with men. Thank you, Father. We give you praise. We give you glory, Lord. Thank you for this morning, Lord. I pray that the entrance of your word will bring peace, will bring joy, will bring happiness, will bring miracles, will bring healing to somebody this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Let chains be broken this morning. Let locks be broken this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Send a word tailor-made to somebody this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. We give you praise. We give you glory, for we are alive because of your mercy. We thank you, for we are counted in the land of the living because of your grace. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen and amen. Brothers and sisters, welcome. I greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus. What a joy to speak to you this morning in the comfort of your homes. I trust this morning that you'll be blessed by the word that I'm going to share with you this morning. Before I proceed, I just want to thank Pastor Peter for giving me such an opportunity to minister to you, to share with you this morning. I do not take it as I don't take it for granted, but I just want to thank you, Pastor Peter, for giving me such an opportunity to share with brethren this morning. So today's message really is about encouraging you people about what God says, especially in this situation that we are in. You know, the world is in crisis. We are walking in unusual times, times that we have never been before. Christianity is in crisis, nations are in crisis, all the churches are in crisis, We've been in lockdown. We have not been going to church since March. So we did, you know, we are in crisis. A world of almost 8 billion has been gripped with such unprecedented fear. We cannot see, you know, coronavirus. We can't see it, but we can certainly see its effect, what it is doing to the nations, devastating the economies of this world has been devastated. Nations has been under lockdown. You know, people canceling their holidays, not meeting their neighbors. We were supposed to travel to the country of Zimbabwe sometime in July, but of course, because of Corona, we couldn't go. So the situation we are in is a very challenging situation to everybody, to every government, communities. Government, they don't know what to do. Nations, they don't know what to do. Brothers and sisters, it's easy to ask, you know, questions. Does God exist at all? When we're in such situations, why would you allow such great suffering to happen? If he is a powerful God, can you not end it all? Can you put an end to the virus? These are sometimes maybe legitimate questions, which I'm sure most of you, maybe including myself, I've asked at one stage. Why is a question that we ask when things goes wrong? We ask, why? Is there a God who can stop this? Is there a God who can stop hurricanes? Is there a God who can stop this war? Is there a God who can stop all these issues that is going on? Who can stop all these death, earthquakes, whatever comes in your life? We sometimes ask ourselves, why? And we are not the first one to ask those questions. Job, in the Bible, he asked the same question. Why was he suffering? You know, he lost everything. And he started to ask why. The wife actually said, why? Curse your God and die. So today, the purpose of this session is just to encourage you about what God says, to encourage you about what the Bible says when we go through these issues. But one thing that I want to let you know, or that I want to assure you, there is nowhere in the Bible, or the Bible does not teach us, that Christians are to be exempt from the tribulations and from natural disasters that come upon the world. We are not exempt at all. There is nowhere in the Bible. The verse they say, oh, we'll be, you know, everything will be fine. In fact, in John 16, verse 33, Jesus himself, he said, I've told you these things so that in you may have peace. That is in Jesus Christ. That's what he promised. In you may have peace, but in this world you have trouble. But take heart, be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. So this morning I'm here to announce to you that you will overcome the world, because greater is he who is inside you than the one who is outside. You serve a mighty God. He will not leave you. He will not forsake you in the mighty name of Jesus. Even if things go wrong, look up to the hills from whence comes your help. Your help comes from the Lord. You will not let your foot stumble. Like I say, the early Christians, they faced a lot of tribulations, a lot of crisis, calamity, personal suffering, a lot of early Christians. You look at Job, the one that I gave you an example earlier on, lost his children, lost his wealth, lost his health, so many, but he kept on holding. Joseph, we know the story, went through a lot of calamities. Jesus Christ himself went through all sorts of issues. He understands. Even if you look at the disciples, all the disciples, they died terrible death. A lot of Christians, early Christians, you know, they experienced all this. But one thing that they did experience was joy in their hearts. They experience joy in their hearts in the midst of those trials, in the midst of troubles, in the middle of whatever depression that was going on. So I pray that God will uphold you. God will give you hope. You hold on. You hold on regardless of whatever is going on in the world. People are suffering. I work in the mental health services. I've seen what is going on there. People have got so many things that is going on in their life. The world has been gripped with fear. Anxiety is on the increase. Depression is on the increase. Suicide ideation is on the increase. Fear is gripping people. But you know what? God is always with you. God will never, 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 never forsake you. I'm here to assure you, my brothers, count it as a joy. You know, the early Christians, they count it as a joy, not as a burden. or this misfortune that they went through. But it was a great honor to serve the Lord, even in the midst of things. So this morning, I'm here to encourage you that it is an honor to serve the Lord. It is a great thing to serve the Lord, even in the midst of this. You may be suffering. I know. You may have lost your job. I understand. You may have lost your beloved one. I understand. But God will never, never, never leave you. He will never forsake you. He will never forsake you. In the mighty name of Jesus, that's my prayer for you. 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 That's one thing that I want to assure you, that God is a God of love. God is a God of love. He will never, He will never let you down. He will never let you down. He understands your trouble. You know, for Paul, you actually say, for I consider the sufferings, that's what they call, I consider the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed to us. There is a suffering that is going on, but there is this glory which shall be revealed to you and me in the mighty name of Jesus. For our afflictions are just for a moment. That's what the Bible says. Our light, in fact, it says our light affliction. Yes, I know Corona sounds, it's difficult, but the Bible says in 2 Corinthians, our light afflictions is just for a moment, is working for us as far as more exceeding eternal weight of glory. This weight of glory that is our way, that is in front of us. You see? It also went to say, for the things which are seen, this is what we are going through, what we are seeing. Things that we are seeing are temporal, but the things which are, which are not seen are eternal. So my brothers and sisters, I'm here to announce to you that His grace is sufficient for you. Irregardless of whatever is going on, His strength is made perfect in your weakness. His strength is made perfect even in this coronavirus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us look at the bigger picture, the glory that is in front of us. Let us hope in Jesus. For I know and I wait for Him. I wait on His promises. My hope is in you. My hope is in you. Because brothers and sisters, if you hope into what the government is saying, there is no good news. If you wait, each time you read newspaper, there are depressing stuff that is going on. You go on Sky, there's depressing news. You go on BBC, there's depressing news. Al Jazeera, there's depressing news. Where is your hope? Is your hope in your finance? Is your hope in your jobs? Jobs are being lost. I've seen shops being closed, there's so many shops. If you go into Newcastle right now, lots of shops have closed, you see. So if you hope into that, I think you'd be very sad, depressed, depressed. Put your hope in Christ. That's what David said. He said, my hope is in you. Hold on to what the Lord says. He has helped you before, and you do it again in the mighty name of Jesus. He has helped you before and is continuing to do it in the mighty name of Jesus. Even the fact that you are able to hear me right now this morning, it means you are alive. Many people have died. Many people have lost their jobs, but you are still alive. I declare to you that God is to have a purpose for you to live in the mighty name of Jesus. He'll give you a fresh beginning. He'll give you a fresh anointing, a fresh start in your life. Even in your marriage, if your marriage has gone apart, God will give you a fresh beginning in the mighty name of Jesus. If your children has gone wayward, God is going to do it again, fresh beginning in the mighty name of Jesus. Even if your health, you're not feeling well, I'm this morning to declare to you that God is a God who is going to give you new hope, new beginning. Hold on to Him. He has helped you before and you do it again. The Lord is good. He is a refuge in times of trouble. Even whatever is going on, He is a refuge to you. He cares for those who trust Him. That's what the Bible says. God is good. God is good. God is my strength. He is a refuge in times of trouble. This trouble that we are in right now, He is a refuge. He is a refuge. He cares for those who trust in you, in Him. That's enough. He trusts, trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. Trust on the Word. See what the Word says about your situation. You know, I know the devil might think he's winning, he thinks he's doing some stuff, you know, especially now they are announcing this second whatever wave, but it will not touch you. I know the Lord, the devil has done some, you know, some devastating stuff in our communities, in our life. But you know what does the word say? You know what? You will not strike again in the mighty name of Jesus. Do not rejoice over me, my enemy. When I fall, I will rise up again. Do not rejoice over my situation, my enemy. For when I fall, I will rise up again. When I sit in darkness of what is going on, the Lord will be my light. That is what you'll be confessing each time. Yes, I'm sitting in this darkness. I'm sitting in this gloomy. I don't know what's happening to my job. I don't know what is happening to my family. I don't know what's happening to my mortgage. I don't know what is happening to my health, but the Lord is my light. I will not be frightened. I will not be dismayed. For the Lord, my God, is with me wherever I go. That should be your song. The Lord, your God, will be with you wherever you go. Trust in the Lord with all your heart during this time. And lean not on your understanding. Because if you lean on your understanding or the government's understanding, they make lots of mistakes. They do come up. They give us this advice today. Tomorrow it changes. They give us this recommendation. Tomorrow is, you know, it changes. So do not, you know, lean on your understanding. Do not be afraid. Do not be frightened. Do not be dismayed. For the Lord God is with you. And one thing that you know, He loves you. He loves you. That's what the Bible says. Irregardless of whatever is going on, God loves you. And we know that. And we know that. When we know that those who love God, all things will work together for good, for those who are called according to His purpose. You and me are according to His purpose. So all things will work well for you in Jesus' name. That's my prayer for you. Trust in the Lord. Do not lean on your understanding. Do not lean on whatever they are saying. In all your ways, in all your ways. That's what the Bible says. Submit to Him and you make your path straight. That's my prayer for you. God will make your path straight in the mighty name of Jesus. Things may go whatever. The lions may grow weak and hungry. That's what the Bible says. But those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. Those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. It is my prayer that you not lack any good thing this morning. It's the Psalms 23. We all know it. Some of us have, you know, memorized it. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil. Even though I walk through the corona, I fear no evil. For you are with me. God is you. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Be comforted by His word in the mighty name of Jesus. It is the Lord who goes before you, in front of you. He'll be with you. He will not leave you. He will not forsake you. Do not fear. Do not be dismayed. Amen. 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 Yes. Anxiety may be brewing. They may be brewing, they may be coming, especially after big announcement. Second phase is coming, maybe twice times two. Where do I stand as a Christian? But the word says, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, including whatever they are predicting, in every situation, by prayer, by petition, by thanksgiving, present your request to God. So this morning, you take time to present your request to God, and the God of peace, who transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ. You guard your heart, guard your mind, because you know what? Your mind is the gateway to your spirit, your mouth, your mind. So guard it, protect it. Do not be anxious about anything. Do not worry, whatever they are saying. But in every situation, yes, keep on praying by fasting, petition, thanksgiving, present your request to Him. That's what my Bible says. Brothers and sisters, the Lord is your rock. He is your rock. The Lord is your rock. He is your fortress. He is your deliverer. My God is my rock. My God is my light. You take refuge in Him. You take shield in Him. Your hope must be in Him. He is your stronghold of your life in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare that you get this in your spirit this morning, in the mighty name of Jesus. In Hebrews 4 tells us that we have got a high priest in heaven, who has passed through the heavens, Jesus Christ is our high priest, the Son of God. Let us hold on to our confession. That's what we are encouraged to do, to hold on to our confessions. Jesus understands. He understands our situation. He has been there before. He is sympathetic to your situation. That's one thing that I know. He is empathetic to your situation. That's one thing that I know. He has been tempted before. He will overcome. He has experienced physical, mental, and emotional, spiritual pain during his years on earth, which I'm sure you are. He even said it on the cross, my God, why have you forsaken me? My God, why have you forsaken me? He was feeling the same thing. So Jesus understands your situation. He understands your suffering completely. And you can bring your knees to him in prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. You can bring your knees to him in Jesus' name. Don't give up, my brother. Don't give up. Don't give up. God will fulfill his promise in your life. You know, you may be probably thinking this way because of this current situation, which is overwhelming to you. But God will never leave you. God will never leave you. God will never leave you. He'll be with you. He'll walk with you. Don't give up. Don't give in. God will manifest in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. I will hear your testimony in Jesus' name. You know what? It's easy for us to forget, you know, what God is doing in our lives, even in the midst of the challenges that you are facing the very minute. Interesting enough, a few weeks ago, our sister Val, she did put some list of things that God is doing in our church. There were a lot of testimonies, touching testimonies, people being healed from all sorts of diseases, people being healed from coronavirus. Even corona is there, but God is healing again in the mighty name of Jesus. He is healing all forms of, you know, disease, cancer, HIV. He is still doing some testimonies, and we will read your testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. Like I said before, even the fact that you are hearing me right now, you are seeing me right now through this medium, God is still with you. He still loves you. It is a testimony, because it is not because you are healthy, because you are fit, that you are alive today. It is because of his mercy. That's my prayer for you, my brother. That's my prayer for you. My prayer for you, even as I continue preaching, is to say, God, please, God, even in these tribulations, even in this affliction that I am, hold me. I'll hold on to you. I hold on to you. I will look up to you. I am more than an overcomer. I am more than a conqueror. Greater is he who is inside me. That's my prayer for you. Lord, lead me to the higher rock. Lead me to the higher rock that is higher than me, that is above me. That's my prayer, whatever is going on. So that's my challenge to you. That's a word of encouragement that I want to encourage with you. And also, if you look into Jeremiah the prophet is one of the major prophets in the Bible, was called at a very young age. I think he ministered, I don't know, Pastor Peter knows this, but I think he ministered for about 51 years. That's what I read somewhere. He was called when he was young. I'm going to paraphrase Jeremiah 18, verse 1 to 6, for those who want to read. There's a story that we are told about Jeremiah being called by God. He was asked to go down to the potter's house, and there he was given a message. So he went down and to the potter's house and saw the potter working on the wheel, but the pot he was shaping from the clay was mud, or it was deformed in the potter's hands. So the potter formed it into another pot, shaping it as it seems best to him, as it seems best to him. There you are, my brother. I think verse 6 is the one that interested me so much. If you read it somewhere, it actually said, he said, can I do with you, Israel? That was God was saying. Can I do with you, Israel, as this potter does? God was asking Israel, can I do with you, Israel? So if you take the word out, Israel, and put your name, if your name is Eva, put Eva. Can I do with you, Eva? Can I put with you, Val? Can I put with you, Pat? Can I put with you, can I do with you, sorry, whatever, John, Mary, or Judith, if you replace it, the word Israel, can I do it for you, Israel? as this potter does. So what did the potter do when the pot went deformed, whatever it was formed in original plan and it did not go according to the plan, decided to form another one. Unfortunately, it didn't work well. He had to form another one. So what am I trying to say? We came into this year, new year, we didn't know things would go this way. We wrote all the plans. We thought everything was going very well. You know, we did everything, you know, put on billboards our visions, we gave all the, you know, on leaflets what we wanted to do, but something along went wrong. But good news is, as in the potter started to make another one. There was a new thing that he formed. And also the potter did not throw away the clay. He could have thrown the clay and say, I'm fed up, I can't do it. But I'm sure this time the potter was very careful making this new object, another one that he was doing, very careful, removing all little stones that were there. So that's what God is doing in your life. God is going to do it again for you. God is going to make it again for you. You will start a new beginning in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. You will start a new thing in your life. God is still God. He is still on the wheel. As the potter is molding, he can discover pieces of stones. So whatever is going on, you will discover some things in your life. God is there to change you in the mighty name of Jesus. God is there to change you. Your first time you encounter God, you know, it was in a chaotic environment when you go to the book of Genesis, but he put everything in order. God is a God of order. You put order in your life. You put your order in your marriage. You put your order in your children. You put your order in our country. You put order in our community, in our government. God is going to put new orders in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, he is here and he will not leave this world in Jesus' mighty name. May he cause the wheel to turn and his beauty, you know, to shine in your life. That's my prayer for you in the mighty name of Jesus. And you make it. You will make it. You will make it in the mighty name of Jesus. That's my prayer for you. This is the time to read the Bible like never before. This is the time to meditate on the word like never before. This is the time to fast like never before. Confess what the word says. It's very key. It's very important. Go to the word. What does the word say about your situation? Never again will I confess I can't. Do not confess I can't. For you know you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. That's what the word says. I can't do this. No, please take this. You can do all things through Christ who gives you strength. Even things you may say, well, am I losing my job? I'm losing my funds, but my finance, I'm losing things in this coronavirus. Please never confess that, for your God will supply you. Yeah, he will supply all your needs according to your riches, according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. He will supply for you. If he's able to supply for the birds, for the grass, are you not more important than these things? So do not worry. Do not worry. Never confess fear. Never. It's easy to confess fear. God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of sound mind. That's what he has given you. He has not given you that spirit. Never. That spirit comes from devil of fear. So don't confess doubt. It's easy to confess doubt and flake of faith. You know what? I doubt this thing that is going on. To God is, you know what? God has given every man the measure of faith. That's what the Bible says. God has given every man the level of faith. So don't think, oh, this, you know, they've got this faith. You have got, you know, you have been given a level of faith in Jesus' name. Do you know, you know what? Just, you know, say who he is in your life. He is your strength. The Lord is the strength of my life. The way it says, the people that know God shall do strong and they will do some exploits. The people who know their God. So in this situation, you do some exploits. You do some exploits. God will always, make you to defeat in everything by Jesus Christ. By Jesus Christ. By Jesus Christ. You may not be feeling well, but what does the word say? With his stripes I am healed. That's what they said. He says himself, he took my infirmities and bore my sicknesses. That's what the way say. casting all your anxieties upon him because he cares for you. That's what they say. He says, so cast all your anxieties on him because he cares for you. That's my prayer for you. I hope, my brothers and sisters, you have been impacted by this word today. Do not be discouraged about what is going on. Yes, I don't undermine what is going on, but do not be discouraged. I've learned in whatsoever state I am therefore content. That's what, you know, Paul says. That's what Paul says. It is my prayer that God will meet you at the point of your need, that God will continue to protect you, even in this virus, even in this corona, even in this financial meltdown, whereby they are predicting things will be very wrong. But I pray that God will be with you. The God whom we serve will be with your family. The God whom we serve will be with this country. The God whom we serve will be with this world, in the mighty name of Jesus. He will not leave us. He will not forsake us, in the mighty name of Jesus. That is my prayer for you. That's my word of encouragement for you. Don't give up. Don't lose hope. In Jesus' mighty name, he understands. He knows you. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you glory, Father Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the word that I've shared with my brethren this morning, Lord. I pray that you meet them at the point of their need. Some of them at the verge of losing their jobs. The Lord, at the verge of losing their marriages, at the verge of losing their children, at the verge of losing their health, Father Lord. I pray, Father Lord, that Jehovah, you will meet us at the point of our very need, even in this situation that we know you are bigger than corona, you are bigger than whatever is going on. In the mighty name of Jesus, we look up to you, the author and finisher of our life. We look up to you, Lord, the cornerstone of our life. We look up to you, Lord, our great deliverer. We look up to you, our strength, our refuge, our healer, cornerstone of my way, our life, the end and the beginning. Thank you, Father. We give you praise. We give you glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Brothers and sisters, like I said, I truly believe you hold on to this word that I've encouraged you with. Read on the scriptures, pray like never before, fast like never before, meditate on the word daily. This word shall not depart upon your mouth day in and day out, so that you remember everything that is written into it. In Jesus' name, I hope to meet up with you next time. In Jesus' name, you have a blessed week. You have a blessed Sunday. In Jesus' mighty name, thank you. Thank you.